Hey guys, it's Jerry Miller. I'm inside I Love CVille with a good friend here, Harrison Keevil, a gentleman I met for the first time while I was a student at the University of Virginia. You know him as the executive chef and co-owner of Keevil and Keevil Grocery and Kitchen. He's also doing amazing things as the executive chef at Commonwealth Skybar. Harrison, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you much.
Yes, great to have you. First, Keevil and Keevil Grocery and Kitchen. You're doing fantastic sandwiches in Belmont. You're making the Belmont neighborhood extremely happy, and you're doing it with a partner who's your wife.
That's right. Jennifer and myself, we've got this little amazing little gourmet shop in the corner of Belmont, and we're making great sandwiches. We're really pushing on some catering right now. We're incorporating, working with this company, Yay Lunch, to help start doing school lunch for kids in the area, so it's really, really exciting.
One of my favorite things about you is you appreciate history, you appreciate tradition, and that certainly exists with your space. You take over the Gibson Grocery Spot, who had for, what, decades?
40 years, yeah.
40 years service Belmont. I'm sure that meant a lot to you.
It does. It's just, I want to take care of this city and our customers and whoever comes from wherever with everything I got and give them 110% of my love and my care and my respect.
You have some dishes that are making quite a name for themselves, as they always have. You start at Brookville Restaurant, where people fall in love with your sandwiches. Then you go to a spot in Belmont where people follow you. Lobster rolls are off the chain.
Yep.
What are some of your favorite dishes, and what are some of the dishes that people have rallied around?
Our Cuban is our best seller. We take Papa Weaver's pork belly, slow roast it with Edwards Country ham, yellow mustard pickle, and McClure Swiss cheese. That is by far our best seller.
What's it like to work with a fantastic front of the house manager and your wife? You guys have kind of matured as business partners from Brookville now to Keevil and Keevil.
It's an exciting day every day. I love working with her. She pushes me harder than anyone else could possibly push me, even myself. So I strive to be great for her and for everyone else.
Great answer. And as a new father myself, I understand the need to work hard and to be motivated by a little one that's counting on you at home. One of the awesome things to think about Keevil and Keevil is you see your daughters in your grocery.
Oh yeah, they come in yesterday. They were there with Jennifer we're a CSA pickup spot for Sweet Greens Farm. So they were there greeting customers, and you'll see them there from time to time when they're not in school.
How has the evolution of Keevil and Keevil happened? You started, what are you, a year, 2 years in?
2 years in.
So 2 years in, what has changed in 2 years?
Really, we're just kind of focusing on a quality of life for us and a quality of life for the customers, and finding the balance that allows us to be parents and be there to take care of the community and kids and cater to anyone's needs.
You talk about quality of life, and do chefs have quality of life these days?
It's something as I get older that I need, especially with my girls getting older, so I need to be there for them when I can, but I still put in the long hours, but being able to find that balance is what's really pushing us these days.
You also are the executive chef at Commonwealth Skybar, and as soon as you took the helm, I've noticed vast improvements with the menu, localizing ingredients to Virginia. It's just been fantastic. First, offer some perspective of why you took this position.
I was just getting the itch to be back in a kitchen, working nights, being on the line with the guys, and just pushing myself physically and mentally to be better and a better chef every day.
Do you see the changes and the vision and the ideas you have coming into effect at Skybar?
Getting there every day. Every day I see something new. Every day we try and work on something new and push and strive to be better every day. And it's a never-ending process to try and be perfect, but we'll get there and we'll take care of people and treat people with love and respect.
Nice answer. As we wind down the interview, I want to put you through a little bit of a Charlottesville gauntlet here.
Yep.
We got a guy who knows Charlottesville food inside and out. When Harrison Keevil has some free time, I know that's few and far between, but when Harrison Keevil has free time, where is he going for dinner, why, and why is he ordering it?
Oh man, I'm probably going, I'm either going to Brasserie Saison or I'm going to Ocart Social, one of the two, where they, mainly because they're just great with our kids. They allow us to be parents, they're welcoming, both restaurants are very supportive of the chef community, so and they're just very supportive of people coming in. So at both Brasserie and Ocart, I can bring my kids, I can have good food, I can not be judged for being there with my kids, and just have a good time and be taken care of.
And you know, I know what that's like now. The baby cries, everyone stares at you. Some places are more welcoming than others. You certainly, as parents, feel feel the stare. I know that now. Harrison Keevil's favorite beer in Charlottesville.
Ooh.
You like beer?
Probably any double IPA that's coming out of Champion.
You love the Dippas?
Yeah, I love
them. You like the high ABVs?
I do, because I'm more of a quality over quantity guy, so I'm just a one pint kind of guy now, so it's really getting as much flavor and balance as possible, and those guys do it.
What would you like to see change, potentially, from the Charlottesville restaurant scene? That's a tough question there for you.
I don't know, just more working together to help raise the community as a whole. Rising tides raise all ships, so it's great as it is right now, but we can always strive to work better, collaborate more, and just push each other to be the best that we can be.
There's two things that constantly come up when I speak to, you know, credible folks like yourself in Charlottesville restaurants. It's, we need help, we need staff, and how does a market that's this size support this many restaurants? Your thoughts on both?
Well, I mean, staffing is a national issue, so it's something you'll find in every single state, but it's really just kind of finding the young people who are willing to work hard from, say, PVCC culinary program. Eric Breckhoff over there is grooming some great talent. So it's really starting them young, making them fall in love, and having them fall in love with the hospitality industry, and being willing to take care of other people, and then just fostering that and just making it bigger and bigger and growing from within.
He's an intellectual guy. He's a tremendous chef. His name is Harrison Keevil. You will see him at Keevil and Keevil Grocery and Kitchen in Belmont. And then you can catch him at nights at Commonwealth Skybar. Charlottesville is absolutely lucky to have this guy in our restaurant scene.